Okay, let's remember that regarding the waters that were gathered together under the firmament, and then the dry land appearing out of that gathering. As I hinted at before, those waters have to be touching the firmament, else how could dry land appear? If dry land can't appear surrounded completely by water, as if there's a core earth in the middle of a big ball of water, there isn't any dry land in the middle of that. So, excuse me. It has to be, that dry land has to appear directly under the heavens, under the atmosphere, where there's, and so that means that there's a surface of water elsewhere. So that means that the dry land is apparently surrounded by water, and we still don't have a shape. That's our problem. There are no shapes in this story. Just planes, different planes of reality or of entity. Planes of entity. My goodness, this is all so poetic. So let's think about that dry land as facing the air or the atmosphere, the firmament, or whatever that is. Now, we're still in this third day. We just have recognized the land. God saw that the land, the Eretz, was good. Now, the minute this compressed Mayim called Eretz appears under the firmament, the very next step is verse 11. God said, again, how many times has he said? A number of times. That is his first act. You should count that up, the number of times that God has said. The first time is verse 3. And we're not going to call the word called the same as said. It's a different word. Verse 6. And there's called and said. Called and said. Verse 9. And now here in verse 11, God said, let the earth bring forth grass, the herb yielding seed, and the fruit tree yielding fruit after his kind, whose seed is in itself, upon the earth. And it was so. Well, that's a lot to have happened where God just said, let it be, and it was. And there's only one time where he said, let it be, and then he made it. And that was when we were talking about the verse 7, when he made the firmament. But in this case, this all seems to come out of the earth. The grass, and there is a gradation of plant life here, botanical life, becoming more complex. We could really spend a lot of time on that, and maybe we will come back to it. But right now, let's just say there's a gradation. Grass is first, and then herb, fruit-bearing grass, herb, and then fruit tree after its kind, and the earth, upon the earth. All these things happened after the Mayim had been apparently compressed. Somehow after it was all brought into one place, dry land appeared. And then this botanical life. As yet, there is no sun. There is no shape. We don't know if this dry land is round in nature, if it is square. We don't know what's underneath it. There's much we do not know. I think it's important to recognize what it is you don't know. The implications of the words that are here are very specific about what you don't know. Always look for what you don't know. Now, he said, let it happen, let the earth bring forth grass. And then interestingly, verse 12, it says, and the earth brought forth grass, the herb yielding seed after his kind, and the tree yielding fruit, whose seed was in itself, after his kind. And God saw that it was good. Okay? He saw that the earth, the eretz, was good. He saw that this botanical development was good. But this business of repeating it, God said, let the earth do this, and then in the next verse, the earth did this. This is another stage in the linguistic structure. It seems as though every day of creation involves a linguistic structure unique to that particular day of creation. That's another observation to make. It's endless, and you know, we're really just scratching the surface here. I wish I could say we were doing more.